Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Let's determine the electric field which surrounds an infinitely large thin plane of positive charges with uniform surface charge density, lowercase sigma. Basically, we have an infinitely large, infinitesimally thin, two-dimensional plane of positive charges which are evenly spread out through the infinite plane. It's like a really, really large sheet of paper with a uniform positive charge per unit area. And our job is to use Gauss's law to determine the electric field which surrounds and is caused by the infinite plane of positive charges. First off, we know the electric field will be normal to and directed away from the infinite plane of positive charges. This is because the plane is infinitely large, therefore every component of the electric field, dE, which is parallel to the plane of charges and is caused by infinitesimally small charged pieces of the plane, dQ, will cancel out, leaving only electric field components of dE, which are perpendicular to the plane and directed away from the plane of charges. Now that we have that figured out, Bobby, what shape shall we choose for our imaginary Gaussian surface?
Well, for the shape of the imaginary Gaussian surface, we are trying to make sure the electric field is either parallel or perpendicular to all the surfaces of the Gaussian surface. The electric field is always horizontal, so the shape of the Gaussian surface needs to have sides which are vertical and horizontal. Could we use a cylinder that has a horizontal axis and has its center on the plane of charges?
Bobby, we certainly can. So, our charges are represented by this piece of paper, and our Gaussian surface is represented by this can of soup. That is our visual representation. We spare no expense here at Flipping Physics. And we can afford demonstrations just like this because of your Patreon donations.
Okay, so, sorry. I know that may have sounded a little sarcastic. I truly do appreciate everyone who donates monthly on Patreon and all donations through other avenues as well. Honestly, I would not be able to make these videos and keep them free for everyone without your financial help. Thanks. Billy, please solve for the electric field in this case.
Absolutely. The imaginary closed Gaussian cylindrical surface is made up of three surfaces: the two ends of the cylinder and the side of the cylinder, which wraps all the way around the cylinder. That means the electric flux through the imaginary closed Gaussian cylindrical surface equals the electric flux through the side of the cylinder, plus the electric flux through the left end of the cylinder, plus the electric flux through the right end of the cylinder. Rather than using the dot product equation, let's use the electric flux equation without the dot product. The angle for the side of the Gaussian cylindrical surface is between a horizontal electric field and the direction of any dA on the side, which is always 90 degrees. That means because the cosine of 90 degrees equals zero, there is zero electric flux through the side of the Gaussian cylinder, which makes sense because the electric field lines do not actually pass through the side of the Gaussian cylinder. The angle between the horizontal electric field and the direction of dA for the left end of the Gaussian cylinder is... actually, the angle for both ends of the Gaussian cylinder are always equal to 0 degrees because the area vectors for each of the ends of the Gaussian cylinder are outward and therefore in the same direction as the electric field. The cosine of 0 degrees equals 1, and the electric field has the same value no matter which dA we are talking about, which means electric field can come out from under the integral. And the integral with respect to area is just area. However, there are two ends, the left and right ends, and they both have the same area, so that is 2 times the area of one end. And that all still equals the charge inside the Gaussian surface divided by the permittivity of free space. Now we need to deal with the right-hand side of the equation. We know surface charge density equals charge over area. When looking at just the charge enclosed by the imaginary Gaussian cylinder, we know the charge in that equation is the charge inside the imaginary Gaussian cylinder, and the area of the charge inside the Gaussian cylinder is the area of one end of the cylinder. That means the charge inside the Gaussian cylinder equals the surface charge density times the area of one end. On the right-hand side of the equation, we can substitute the surface charge density times the area of just one end, and
everybody brought the area of one end of the Gaussian cylinder to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
And we get that the magnitude of the electric field which surrounds and is caused by an infinitely large, thin plane of charges equals surface charge density divided by the quantity 2 times permittivity of free space.
Very nice, Billy. Let's review a couple of things. Notice the electric field is uniform and independent of distance from the plane of charges. This is because the plane of charges is infinitely large. Also, I just want to review that the Gaussian surface we chose has Gaussian surface area vectors that are either parallel to or perpendicular to the electric field. Realize that means we could have chosen a rectangular box as our imaginary closed Gaussian surface. That would have given the exact same electric field. And let's take this example one step further. What if we add an equal magnitude parallel infinite plane of negative charges? Bo, what will happen then? Oh, and realize the surface charge density in the equation now refers to the magnitude of the surface charge density, which is the same for both infinite planes of charges. Bo?
Well, the electric field from the positively charged plate is uniform in magnitude everywhere. Before we add the electric field from the equal magnitude negatively charged plane, let's make the electric field from the positively charged plane blue.
Actually, let's remove the negatively charged plane for a moment so we can visualize what the electric field fully looks like from just the positively charged plane. Now let's switch to just the negatively charged plane. The electric field from the negatively charged plane, let's make it red, is also uniform everywhere. However, that electric field points towards the negatively charged plane because electric fields are defined using a small positive test charge, and a positive test charge would be attracted to the negatively charged plane. And now let's add back the positively charged plane and its blue electric field. Okay. Outside the two parallel, oppositely charged planes, the electric fields are equal in magnitude. However, they are opposite in direction. Therefore, the electric field outside the two parallel planes of charge is zero. However, between the two parallel planes of charge, the two electric fields are in the same direction. Therefore, the electric field between the parallel plates of charge is just 2 times the electric field of one plane of charges. Substitute in surface charge density over 2 times the permittivity of free space, and we get that the electric field that exists between the two parallel planes of charge with equal magnitude but opposite sign is equal to surface charge density over permittivity of free space.
Well done, Bo. Thanks. And realize, we have now begun our journey towards determining the capacitance of an ideal parallel plate capacitor.
Cool!
Yay!
Also, notice that the positively charged particle moving through a constant electric field like this will experience an electrostatic force in the direction of the electric field. This force will be constant and equal to the charge of the particle times the magnitude of the electric field. In other words, the motion of a charged particle through a constant electric field will have similar characteristics to a mass moving through a constant gravitational field near the surface of a planet.
Oh, that is just like projectile motion.
Exactly. This is very similar to projectile motion. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.